Hi everyone, welcome back to Zhong Andrew. In this video, I'm going to share the steps I use to create the environment you see on screen. Recently, I came across a new workflow and spent some time learning it, and today I want to share it with you. We'll be using a new PCC mode in Unreal Engine 5.7 to build this environment. First, you need to enable the PCC Framework plugin. You can go to plugins, search for PCC, enable it there. And you can also enable the PCC Samples plugin if you want to explore more examples and learn how PCC works in practice. Next, I create a simple landscape using landscape mode. The material I'm using here was downloaded from Unreal Sensi. You just need to enter your information and you can download it for free. And I also did some basic sculpting here. I have a basic rose here and I've already applied a material to it. I'm using a blend asset to blend the road with the landscape. I also providing this asset for free on Gumroad, so you can download and use it. Next, I switch to PCC mode and use the PCC experiment tool to create the road. First, I add the mesh that will be powered along the spline. Then, if you scroll down, you will see different apply drawing modes. Such as click or do tangent free draw and tangent direct. In this case, I will use click or do tangent to draw the road mesh. Next, I adjust the resample distance. You can tweak this value depending on the road shape and how smooth you want the apply to be. So you can adjust the overall scale, position, and rotation using the global transform settings. And we can enable slab to surface to align the S-Play with the surface. The right cut setting control where the S-Play can be drawn, whether it's on mesh, on landscape, or both. With just a few basic steps, we already have a pretty light road here, and so you can try it now. Next, we will move on to the PCC spacing tool. This is a very useful tool for placing props along spline. I will use a method I downloaded from Fab to explain this to you. In the polar menus, we can control the numbers of objects, the spacing, and the roundness of objects along the appliance. Feel free to try adjusting their settings. They are actually really nice to work with. We can also spawn a blueprint actors, recon and more by using the actor class options. So we can also adjust everything globally using global transforms just like before. You can also adjust the mean and max transform values of the actors, which helps add a lot of more randomness, but in this case, I don't really need to do it. In the project sessions, we also have slab to surface alignment. This is very useful for placing street lights, markers, or other props neatly along a straight path. Next, I will introduce a very useful BCG tool for creating modular assets called the Lineagrama tool. Here, I use to create the fan lines along the road. I have set up a few basic rules here. You can take a look at and how it works first, and then try it out yourself. First, I have three modular barrier mesh here. I assign symbols A, B, and C to them so I can use them in grammar rules above. You can think of A, B, and C as symbols. Can correspond to each mesh. The asterisk means that mesh will loop continuously until the mesh ends. So when we set the rule as A, B asterisk, C, it means mesh A at the beginning, then mesh B looping along the S-line, and finally mesh C at the end. You can follow what I'm doing on screen to see how it works. After that, you can try applying this on your own projects. It's very useful for creating fans, buildings, and other modular structures. Next, we'll move on PCG paint tab. First, I will use place tool to paint some ground meshes. It works similarly to foliage painting, but it gives you more mesh control after painting, which is very convenient. After adding the static meshes, you can try painting them and see how it works. You can also filter adjust the global transform and the random actor transforms, allowing the object to be much more customizable. The menu is quite similar to the other PCG tools we used earlier. Here, I will test it directly on screen so you can see how it works. In the debug section, we can see the position of the object and the number of objects we've painted. I will paint some rocks, meshes and tree roots around the road to add more detail. And one more thing, if any meshes stick out anywhere we don't want, we can always go back and scrub the landscape again to fix it properly. Here I also use it to paint trees and just are closer to the camera, so I can get a better composition. Here, can you see the lag and small rust cluster? I used the PCC Layer Splash Tools actor to paint them. Let's take a look at how I did. Here we have three layers, so we need to think about how to make the layers work together harmoniously. First, for layer zeros, I will use it for leaves and possibly some branch and small rock. Here we can adjust the transform settings for each layer, allowing us to fine-tune the position and scale to fit properly. The next layer will be low grass. Switch to layer 2 in data eastern section, then you can start painting. And for the final layers, we will use taller vegetation to add more realism to grass and plant cluster. Just watch and what I'm doing on screen and wait for a result. It's actually very convenient. So with just few simple steps, we can create fairly natural looking bubbles and small grass layers, especially when they place close the camera. Here I will introduce the area tools apply, which is very useful because it allows us to draw custom shape areas. I use it to place taller tree in the distance. The workflow is similar to previous PCC tools. Just select a few tree types, what I do on screen, and then try it yourself. And here we also have the volume tool and PCC biome, which are very useful for the kind of workflow. I will introduce them in upcoming videos. I also added some black stone slab to add more variety to the scenes. It helps make the scene feel more realistic and aesthetic. And here, can you see I also add a bit falling leaf effect to enhance the visual of this scene. That pack I'm using is the Atmos. You can download and use it as well. So in this video, we'll explore the basic of PCC mode in Unreal 5.7, which is a major framework improvement. We use some core tools to create an environment scene together. In the next video, I will go deeper and show more advanced application of PCC. And finally, thank you for watching, and I will see you in the next video. Bye bye, and see you soon.